the dude died, and it's just now they're not together anymore. And I wish I would have paid better attention.
Speaking of Z, he's on the fucking tube right now. At least he's on mine. Showing some old school shit.
Yeah, Pantera's. I love Pantera.
Dimebag Darrell, the fucking man.
Heck yeah.
My buddy Gabe that shot himself in the head had his signature guitar. That motherfucker's expensive. God.
Oh wow.
He fucking cherished that damn thing. He did. But Gabe knows shit. My buddy Gabe ended up being 7 foot fucking tall. His knees wasn't working very well. It got to the point where he couldn't walk. And his mom and dad done passed away and all this shit. Shit ton of medical bills. And him and his brother were just done. His brother was a raging alcoholic. And poor guy. I mean, it's one of those things. You know, he never talked about hurting himself or anything like that. And they left a letter and said that they were done. That they didn't want nobody taking care of them. They didn't want nobody taking on their problems or anything like that. He didn't want to have to depend on nobody. And they did. His brother sat there in the living room with him. He shot his brother in the head, then turned the gun on himself. And
oh my gosh, that's sad. That's horrible.
Surprised they didn't condemn the house, to be honest with you. The house was always nasty. I mean, they just, unfortunately, just lived that type of lifestyle. But, yeah, there was him not being able to get up. He's, you know, I won't go into too much detail. They just needed to condemn the house. But the family took it over and cleaned it up. So.
It's sad for someone to do that. To feel like that there's just nothing else left, you know, that they can do to make their life happy. That's really sad.
Yeah. It is. Yeah.
Hold on one second. You just never know what anybody's going through, because sometimes people don't when they talk about it. Like, I know I've always had a hard time with that in my life, talking about things that bother me and stuff. So I know it's hard to get through that wall, but if you're feeling that bad, you definitely need to get to talk to somebody.
It's the people that don't talk about it is the ones we need to worry about. But it's kind of hard to worry about if the person
you're not aware.
Yeah, exactly, and whatnot. Matt put in here, David Gorey said that there's one reason why Nirvana doesn't get back together. Courtney Love. I was thinking not Kurt Cobain. You know, everybody had their thoughts thinking that Courtney Love was the one that shot Kirk in the head.
I think she did.
Do you?
I really do.
So I think he shot himself.
Yeah. Well, did you ever see the movie Soaked in Bleach?
No.
You need to watch that. That shit gave me chills. It was the private investigator that Courtney Love hired to investigate, to find Kurt. And there's just so much stuff. Even he believes that she did it. There's just too much stuff. And like I said, it just gave me chills watching it. So definitely, if you get a chance, watch that, Soaked in Bleach. But I heard that she does try to block a lot of Nirvana stuff. Like she is, I guess, has custody over all the music stuff or whatever, the rights to it. And I heard that she does try to block a lot of crap for them to make it harder. But I don't think it would be the same without Kurt Cobain, so...
No, it wouldn't be. You can't take and mimic his voice.
No, his voice is raw and real.
You can't mimic that. You know, there's a few bands out there that take and, you know, they'll replace their singers and stuff like that, and the music still sounds good, but this right here, we're going to play Nirvana song right now. This is the reason why you cannot mimic Kurt Cobain. Lady Liberty just sent me a picture of the fucking shotgun. That's a big motherfucker.
Yeah, you really need to watch Shocked and Bleach if you haven't, because it's pretty telling. It's crazy.
Yeah,
Like I said, it give me cold chills, and I don't get cold chills easy.
I'm gonna have to bring that fucker up. I might do it after we get off the show. I might bring it up. I got bring it up on see if I can find it on YouTube. If I find it on YouTube, then that'd be badass, but it's gotta be on there by now. Especially that old ass
Probably
fucker.
is. Yeah, it probably is. But yeah, he has such a raw voice. Just like even when he did like the MTV Unplugged, oh my gosh. When he did the Where'd You Sleep Last Night and Lake of Fire, he just sounded so good even then, Live. It was just he was awesome. Awesome.
Hey, I'm looking at pictures of the door now. Glass by the doorknob, and then you can see glass inside the fucking door too. From what Heather's showing me. God almighty. Oh damn, I might have to
Well, and the thing is, the
reclaim my
investigator went out there
resolution.
and they searched the house a couple times, and not once did she tell him to search above the garage where he was found. She never mentioned that part, and I don't know. There's just a lot of different things that just did not add up, and I don't know. It's just,
Well, I
plus
mean,
he was planning on divorcing her right before it happened, so.
yeah, damn.
She made money better off with him dead, I guess. So that's what
And
her theory
she
was.
sit there and sent me a picture too of looks like a heroin kit and a couple of needles, a spoon, a lighter. I don't know what's in that
Yeah,
fucking
I'll put
tube.
back in the box neatly.
Yeah.
Like, how would, and that's another thing they were saying with the amount that it was in his body. Like, how would you have time to put all your stuff away neatly, then get settled in and to where you could shoot yourself? And he had his shoes on, so how did he? He didn't do it with his toe, like she was saying. So how? I mean, it just
Yeah.
and the way it laid. Like once you die, your body stays that in that position, and it just yeah, just things didn't look right. But like I said, she had him cremated so quick that they couldn't really do much investigation on it.
Yeah, that I do remember them saying that she did get rid of the body too fucking quick, for them to do any further looks and any tests into his body. But
Yeah.
I've never done heroin. I've never tried it, and I've really never hung around any heroin addicts that I'm aware of. But from what I've seen on the movies and shit, it looks like it's one of those drugs that if you do take too much of, how can you even fucking function? You know what I mean?
Thank you. You usually would nod off and not that I've ever done it. I just know I do know people that did use they used to have a habit, and generally you just nod off and you're kind of just. Like a zombie, kind of. So,
Right. Yeah, that's nuts. That's fucking nuts. Well,
yeah,
I looks
gotta
like
watch.
my resolution on what happened to Kurt Cobain has finally changed after all these years. Because I was one of the ones that's like, nah, he fucking shot himself. Get over it. Get over it. But
No,
now
he
after
was
seeing
actually
that.
in a happy place, and he had left rehab. I don't want to give away too much of the movie, but he had left rehab and was planning on divorcing her, and like he was avoiding her. And like I said, I think that she thought, oh well, if he divorces me, because her she wasn't doing that well, and then and if he died, she would make all the money off of it, and she did. And then she come out with her album like what a week or two later after he died.
None of her shit was any fucking good. I really don't think. Everybody's like, oh, Kurt Cobain's this nasty motherfucker. No, that's just his grunge look. Courtney Love
Right.
was a nasty bitch.
Yeah.
That,
Well,
yeah.
I can't lie. I jammed out to a couple of her songs back in the day, but I don't know. I just she it I don't think she would have got that popularity if it wasn't for him.
Well, of course not. Of course not. Yeah, I don't think she'd have got that popularity either. Uh-oh. Let's see this picture. Okay, here's a shoe. I don't know what's in the bag. It looks like a fucking battery. Or shotgun shells.
Yeah, like I said,
Unopened ammo
definitely,
box.
definitely,
Okay.
watch it. That's your homework, okay?
That's my homework.
Yep. Just like you had me watch a video, this is your homework.
I Alright, we got you on Freedom fucking Friday. We'll come back with some BAM! Got you! Now, sis, just showed me that box of fucking unopened ammo. Damn. Cobain was... Yes, he was a fucking genius. I have to agree with you on that one.
He was.
You know, it was... And, you know, just like, you know... Just like some of the other greats that are no longer with us. I mean, they put their heart and soul... And some of these songs, you sit here and you wonder, you know, what's really going on with these people's lives and stuff. Because if you look at it, a lot of musicians, that's what they fucking write about.